All right, I'm going to show you how to get connected to SQL Server, but I'm also going to show you a few little tidbits along the way to look out for while you're trying to get connected to SQL Server, especially when you're doing it with a local Docker Compose YAML file or Docker container, and you need to make sure certain things are lined up so you can actually get connected. So here's what you got to do. The first thing, if you don't have an environment already set up, just go out to the Quick Start with Docker documentation, scroll down and grab the wget file, or the file, grab the Docker Compose YAML file via the wget example right here. So I'll make a directory and call it Hasura SQL Server example. Navigate into that, and then I'm going to wget the Docker Compose file. All right, so I've retrieved that. There it is. Let's open it up in code and take a look at what we have already. All right, in the Docker Compose file, we have Postgres and we have Hasura V2 Alpha 10. Right now, we're gonna leave Postgres in there because we're gonna need that too, but we're gonna add SQL Server. So I'm gonna add a SQL Server service. I'm using the mcr.microsoft.com/msql server 2019 GA Ubuntu 16.04. Now, you could probably use any of the available SQL Server images out there, but that's the one that I'm using for this example, so I know that it works. Then I'm going to give it a name, and I do this just to make things a little easier to reference if I'm automating things or something like that. Set it to restart if anything happens. Then I want to open up the ports. We'll open up ports 1433 to 1433. Which is the SQL Server port to connect to it and to work with that database. Then I'm gonna set some environment variables. For SQL Server specifically, you need to set the accept EULA and set it to yes. Then you need to set the SA password for the SA account to log in with. And I'm just gonna make it Hasura MS SQL 9. No real reason with that number. That's just what I picked. And then the MS SQL PID is whether it's the enterprise, developer, or other version of SQL Server. In this particular example, I'm going to use Express just to keep it super simple, single instance running, etc., for this SQL Server. Now with all that done, I have enough to start SQL Server now, but there's a few other little things that you'll need. One, make sure that it starts first before Hasura starts up. So I'm gonna add SQL Server here. And then what you can do at this point is you can add an environment variable that you would use for the connection, or you can use the ODBC connection string itself to actually connect to the database once you've already started this up. So I could start it right now, but let's go ahead and add an environment variable called Hasura SQL Server connection string. All right, and now, the connection string that I want to put in there, driver equals ODBC driver 17 for SQL Server. Okay, that's the name of the driver. Then you want to set the server, which in this case, this is a tricky part. If you are pointing this at an individually running SQL Server instance locally on a Windows machine or Windows Server or Ubuntu Server or something like that, you would need to put the name of the server per the DNS or whatever the lookup is here. Or you would have to put the IP of the server here. In this particular situation though, we are going to put this reference, the container reference to the server so that it knows which container it's actually referring to. So in that situation, we would put SQL Server, all right? So that's going to point it directly at the SQL Express instance of the SQL Server that is running on that container. Then we'll designate the database. I'm going to connect to master database because I know that's there. That's one of the default databases on the SQL Server. Then we'll set the user ID to SA, so system administrator, and then password, we're going to set to that password that I made just a minute ago. And to make sure I get it right, I like to copy and paste the password. There we go. So closing semicolon there, and we should have a good connection string. And now, can bounce out here. There's our file. I'm gonna use docker compose up -d. And there we go. The three instances of the images are running as containers now, and we can reference to those. The easiest way to do that, that I like to do, is do a Hasura init, and that sets up the migration folder, etc. But then I can just navigate into that, since this is a locally running environment, and now just type Hasura console, and it's going to bring up the active instantiated console and point it at what has been set up via the Docker compose. Now, of course, we don't have the SQL Server connection in here yet, but if I go to manage, connect database, environment variable, I'll pick test, SQL Server, and then let's bounce back over there, get the connection string, come back over here, paste it in, and connect to database. And there we go. We're now connected to the SQL Server database.